I'm here at the office of Hyderabad's Police Commissioner, Mr. Anjani Kumar. As you can see, his table desk, in fact, has a green cover to ensure that social distance is, in fact, maintained. And today we are talking about a day when there are containment zones that have been identified and you are putting up big barricades there. What happens inside those barricades and what kind of movement is allowed, and are essentials allowed to go in and out?
Yes, city of Hyderabad, initially we have identified 12 and now the number may go to 15, what we call the containment zone. Now the containment zone, like morning I visited one place called Dwarka. It is in the central zone limit in Hyderabad colony. So this area has about seven lanes which has been barricaded by the R&B department, and the barricading is about 7 to 8 feet height so that nobody can scale it. And there would be one opening where essential goods and other things would be supplied from. The selection of these area has been such that the basic things which are available, which are required for the community inside, is already available. There is a shop inside, and the refueling can be done once in a day, or depending on the situation, twice in a day. This particular area, there are 7,000 dwellings. So we, along with the secretary, R&B and all, GHMC commissioner, we spoke to the community. We told them about the need to have this, because in case we want to stop the spread, we have to have this containment strategy. Similarly, at all these places, there will be CCTV camera, and particularly at the place where the ingress and the outgress is allowed for special purpose, like movement of essential item. All the places by evening, we'll see that the barricading is done. And there are some areas like Mallepalli and all where large number of barricading is required. So there is a scheduled joint inspection in the afternoon at 3 o'clock. We'll be going there.
Hyderabad reports the highest number of cases within Telangana. That initially seemed obvious because more number of foreign returnees may be there. But of course, with the Markaz Tablighi meeting that we have, have all the numbers now been identified? Is that the understanding of the police?
Yes. Hyderabad, in fact, we were one of the first to realize and understand the reality. And with the help of the state intelligence, central intelligence, then Foreign Registration Office, FRRO, the entire profiling of all the train passengers, profiling of all the air passengers, the cell phone data analysis, we have 100% verified each and every person who has come from Delhi, and foreigners also. The primary contact is also now identified. The secondary and the tertiary contact, that number is adding. So we are still keeping that as a dynamic factor. And we have geolocated everything, those who are quarantined, institutional quarantined or home quarantined. And we also have developed an app which will be a tool in the hand of all the SHOs, all the local health workers, to know the entire tree of the movement of these people.
There is a lot of apprehension, containment zone, what really happens, what it entails for the people. You're saying within the containment zone, they will not be able to come outside, or anyone from outside go inside. What really does it entail?
Yes, the GHMC and all of us put together, our work, our task is to see that each of these containment area, it should be self-sufficient with regard to the essential item. And it is our responsibility along with GHMC to see that those things are frequently getting refilled. Now, some of the houses where the number is there or positive people were there, those houses people will not be allowed to come out. They will remain inside. And whatever is need to be supplied to them, it will be supplied to them there at their doorstep.
Okay. And right now, you're talking about a dozen or about 15 of such containment zones. And in Hyderabad, do you expect that these numbers could actually go up, because it's a dynamically changing situation?
You see, right now, when we see Hyderabad and we compare it with Delhi, when we compare it with Maharashtra or Tamil Nadu, things are much better in Hyderabad. That way, there is nothing to worry about. And however, there is always a need to be very alert, to be cautious. As on now, in the last 2-3 days, there has not been an increase in the graph, and we are following the movement of the graph very carefully. Depending on the situation, as and when it comes, if it increases, then we have to improve our strategy and we have to fine-tune the response mechanism.
Doctors and policemen, of course, frontline of this entire battle. How are you specifically protecting your people?
Yes, that is an important issue. Hyderabad city, at any given time, we have about 4,500 to 6,000 people from police department deployed, particularly those who are on the check post. Each of them have been provided with mask. They have been given basic training about following the safety principles, like not touching anybody, wearing hand gloves, and maintaining 5 to 7 feet distance. These are the things. And apart from that, every check post have been supplied with soap and hand sanitizers. So these are the things which we are taking care of, and I'm sure our officers are careful enough. Every night we all go out, we senior officers, we see personally each and every check post and talk to them, brief them about the need to be safe and secure.
And in this case also, it's a community that's been taken into confidence for the containment also, you're saying?
Yes, absolutely. Community has to be with us, because no effort from any department will be successful unless and until the community is with us. So there has been a campaign, there has been an awareness campaign, there has been talking to all the people. So we are carrying the community along with us.
Thank you so much. So the Hyderabad Police, while maintaining relations with the community and trying to convince them this is something that needs to be done in the larger interest of this pandemic not spreading further within the city. In Hyderabad, with camera person Nagraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.